الطلاق, you divorce 3 times. Okay? And here for the divorce or العدة, بالنسبة للطلاق هناك يعني العدة أو الطلاق البينوني, بينون رجعة رجعي, طلاق رجعي أو طلاق غير رجعي. الطلاق الرجعي هو الذي عندما يرجع الزوج زوجته في خلال فترة العدة. We have two things in طلاق, طلاق رجعي and طلاق غير رجعي. طلاق رجعي means when someone divorces his wife and then get his wife back to the marriage again. And this happens by two means. Number one, when he says to her, you know, I want you to be again my wife, just by saying that, or by having physical intercourse with him. Okay, so by having physical relationship with her, whether he meant to get her back or not, she will be back. Okay, by just any physical relationship with the wife, then she will be again, you know, his wife, to get her again to, yani, to the marriage life. Yes, brother. Yes. Some ulama said the muqaddimat, hugging, but wallahu ta'ala alam, once you have the real relationship, physical relationship with the wife, then she will be back to the isma. We call it to the isma. Isma means to the real marriage. Real marriage life, inshallah. طيب. So now we are talking about the khitbah during that period. We are talking about the khitbah during that period. قال العلماء لا يجوز خطبة المرأة المطلقة أو خطبة المرأة المتوفى عنها زوجها. So it is not allowed to have the خطبة or to do the خطبة, the direct خطبة, okay, whether the divorced woman or the woman whom her husband passed away. Okay, we cannot do that. And when we say خطبة يا إخواني, we have to differentiate between two things. التصريح بالخطبة والتعريض بالخطبة. التصريح بالخطبة هو الذهاب بشكل مباشر لولي المرأة أو للمرأة إذا كانت أمرها بيدها. فهذا لا يجوز أبدا. لا في هذا الحال ولا في هذا الحال, لا في حالة الطلاق ولا في حالة إذا توفي عنها زوجها. So to do the خطبة direct, okay, علماء are agreed we cannot do that, okay, we cannot do that. But the disagreement was indirect, which is, it is mentioned in the Quran that it is okay, وَلَا جُنَاحَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي مَا عَرَّضْتُمْ بِهِ مِنْ خِطْبَةِ النِّسَاءِ, which means you mention to the woman indirectly about the marriage. How? For example, you say to the wali, to the guardian, or to her, something you know, about the marriage, about her. يعني for example, you know, you are a good woman and there is a lot of people, you know, will be interested in you inshallah. So are you doing this directly? No, this is indirect. And she will understand, or the guardian will understand, you know, you have an interest. Okay, this is number one. Or when you say to the wali, mashallah, she is a good wife. You know, anything that, you know, you can understand from it that you have an interest in that woman. Not directly, salamu alaykum, she is still in her idda. Wallahi, akhi, I'm really interested in your daughter or in your sister. And she's still in the idda. We cannot do that. Okay? Now, we need to be more specific. We need to be more specific about or differentiate between al-iddah min mawt wal-iddah min talaq. We need to be more specific. You know, when we speak about the iddah from the death or the iddah from talaq, divorce. Okay? Now, at-ta'ridu, the indirect khitbah. The indirect khitbah. For the death, it is fine. During the iddah time. What is the proof? The ayah is very clear. But now the ulama were disagreed about what? About the divorce, the indirect khitbah during the talaq raj'i. Now, the talaq raj'i, ya ikhwani, when the husband can get his wife, you know, again back to the marriage. So basically, it is whether after the first talaq or the second talaq. After the first talaq, this is called talaqun raj'i. Or after the second talaq, it's called talaqun raj'i. He still can, you know, that idda after the first talaq or the idda after the second talaq, still it's called what? Talaqun raj'i. But after the third talaq, that's it. Okay, she's divorced now. The husband cannot get her back until what, or unless she get married to another one, and then she divorced from the second husband, and then she marry her again. طيب. فالآن نحن نتكلم عن الخطبة في الطلاق الرجعي. اختلف العلماء حول ذلك. The ulama were disagreed about that. And we are speaking about what? The indirect, at-ta'rid, not the direct. طيب. الحنفية ماذا قالوا؟ الحنفية قالوا لا يجوز التعريض للمرأة المعتدة بطلاق رجعي. حنفي مذهب, they said you cannot even, you know, do the خطبة, even the indirect. Even the indirect. Why? They said that might open the door for some women to lie about their iddah. See the Ahnaf?
Very smart.
لماذا قال الأحناف أنه لا يجوز التعريض بخطبة المرأة إذا كان يعني من طلاق رجعي؟ قالوا لأن هذا سيفتح الباب أمام بعض النساء للكذب حول العدة. Now here the thing. Can we know about, you know, the عدة from her عدة from divorce? Can we know exactly when it started, when it ends? We cannot. Why? Because that depends on the hayd or tuhur. And no one can know about that except the woman. But the death, 4 months and 10 days, once the man dies, right, the iddah will start. So they know, oh, he dies, you know, on Saturday in that date. So they can count. Anyone can, you know, count. So she cannot lie, you know, for that. But for the subhanAllah, her hayd, no one know about that except her. That's why Ahnaf says we cannot do that, because we don't, you know, she maybe she just want to get married. She's in need. She just want to get married. That's it. Maybe she lies. Allahu a'lam. طيب. فهذا الأمر الأول. هذا بالنسبة للأحناف. So this is for the Hanafi madhab. For the Maliki and Hanbali, they said, قالوا التصريح لا يجوز ولكن التعريض جائز. They said to do it directly, it is you know, impermissible, but indirect, it is permissible. The opposite of Hanafi madhab. طيب, why? They said because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed it. Yes, that contest was about what? About, you know, the death. So it is also the same thing for the divorce. Okay. Al-Shafi'iyya, they have two opinions. One of them like Hanafi madhab, one of them like Maliki and Hanbali madhab. What is the most correct opinion? إذن المالكية والحنابلة قالوا بجواز التعريض للمرأة المعتدة من طلاق بائن بينون صورة أو من طلاق رجعي, أجازوا ذلك واستدلوا على ذلك بالآية. أما بالنسبة للشافعية فالشافعية عندهم قولان, قول كالأحناف وقول كالمالكية والحنبلية. ما هو الراجح؟ الراجح يا أخواني والله تعالى أعلم أنه ينظر في الطلاق نفسه. والله أعلم, strongest opinion is to differentiate between طلاق رجعي and طلاق غير رجعي. Okay, why? If it is talaq rajai, the talaq after the first talaq, the idda after the first talaq, or the idda after the second talaq. Now, what is our priority here? Is our priority to separate the wife from the husband, or to keep this marriage exist? To keep this marriage exist, right? So it is the wisdom to try to fix this relationship, especially if there are kids between them. Not to tell her okay, or to allow people okay, do the indirect khutbah, it is fine. Because once that happened, once we allow that, then that will weakness the opportunity for them to go back together. Because, you know, when the divorce happens, there will be a lot of disagreements, a lot of challenges, right? A lot of difficulties between them. So when the woman see someone offer her indirectly for marriage, she will go right away. She will, you know, yani she will understand he's interested in her. So basically she will cut and close every door, you know, for her husband, and yet she's still her husband. Yet she's still her husband. Okay, khwani. What if the idda ends? What if the idda ends, by the way, from the first divorce or from the second divorce? Can her husband get her back by saying no? خلاص, now there is no marriage, right? But he can get her back by what? By new contract, and she has to agree. Now again, what is our priority? If the idda ends, our priority is, even if the idda ends and if they got to an agreement between them, no, we prefer for her to go back to her husband, to the first husband, not to, you know, close the door and to cut everything for the first husband. Again, ya akhwani, especially if there are kids. Okay? Because we want to keep this family. We don't want to break the family. طيب؟ إذن الراجح في المسألة والله تعالى أعلم أن نفرق بين الطلاق الرجعي وغير الرجعي. إذا كانت المرأة معتدة من طلاق رجعي فالأولى ألا نسمح للخطبة أو للتعريض للخطبة, لأنه نريد أن نبقي عرى, يعني عرى الزوجية ما انتهت أصلا, ما زالت هي زوجته, ما زالت هي زوجته. فإذا فتحنا الباب مع تلك المشاكل التي حدثت بينها وبينه, لأنه لماذا تم الطلاق أصلا؟ لأنه في مشاكل. لم يتم الطلاق هكذا والله, يعني you will not find someone, you know, a husband and a wife sitting and they are drinking tea together and cake. Hey my wife, honey, you know what, you are divorced. No one will do that. Divorce will happen because there is problems and they couldn't fix it. يعني الطلاق سيحدث لأنه هناك مشاكل. ما حدا والله راح يطلق زوجته هم وعم بيشربوا كاسة شاي. هذا ما يتم, هذا لا, يعني غير معقول. لابد أن يكون هناك مشاكل معينة وكذا, وما استطاعوا على حلها أو حلت أو ما حلت, المهم يعني يحصل هناك الطلاق. فالشاهد, إذا كان الطلاق من, إذا كانت العدة من طلاق رجعي, والله أعلم أنه لا يجوز التعريض للخطبة. ماذا لو انتهت هذه العدة؟ ماذا لو انتهت هذه العدة من يعني بعد الطلاق الأول أو بعد الطلاق الثاني؟ نقول الأفضل أو الأولوية هنا, إذا كان هناك مجال, إذا كان الزوج يعني يريد أن يرجع زوجته ووصل لاتفاق, أن نرجعهما حفاظا على هذه الأسرة. جيد. ولكن إذا كانت العدة من طلاق غير رجعي, من طلاق غير رجعي, يعني بعد الطلقة الثالثة, فإنه يجوز التعريض بالزواج أو بالخطبة. So if the عدّة after the third divorce, then we can, you know, do the khitbah or show our interest indirect way. Okay, Akhwani? Any questions so far? Yes. You know what, brother? Can we do the questions in the end? Remember we said, you know, the people who are watching us, they will not maybe follow us in that. طيب, إن شاء الله. الآن نصل إلى مسألة الخطبة على الخطبة. To do the خطبة in a time when there is another خطبة. Okay? So, for example, someone went to do the khutbah. You know, to another, a woman, and there is another brother or another man is interested in the same woman. So now the question is, can he go and do the khitbah or not? Okay, we're gonna talk about this. طبعاً, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in the hadith, لا يخطب الرجل على خطبة الرجل حتى يترك الخاطب قبله أو يأذن له. إذن لا يجوز أن يخطب رجل على خطبة أخيه حتى يترك الأول أو أن يأذن له. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the hadith, he said, it is not allowed for someone to do a khitbah if there is a first khitbah to the same woman, except if the first khatib, if the first man allowed him or agreed, or he cancelled his khitbah with that lady. Okay, again, Muhammad went to, you know, to engage or to, you know, to show his interest to Fatima. There is not just Muhammad who is interested in Fatima, but we have whom? We have Hamza interested in Fatima. Okay, now Muhammad already talked about Fatima. He already went to the guardian and he, you know, told him that I'm interested. Remember, let me go back again and remind you what is the khitbah means. Proposal, wa'd. It is just what basically, يعني you are booking basically that you know, that lady. It is a promise. Okay, it is a promise. طيب, so كان الآن حمزة goes and show his interest, you know, to Fatima, yes or no? The answer is no. But if Muhammad cancelled his khitbah, then he can. Or if Muhammad say to Hamza, you know what Hamza, it's fine akhi, just go, whatever happens happens, if they want you, may Allah inshallah yani make it very successful for you. طيب الان اذا هذا هو الحكم يا اخواني بالنسبه لي قضيه الخطبه. هنا لابد أن نتحدث عن بعض الأمور في هذه النقطة بالذات. طيب, عندنا بعض حالات. We have some examples. What if the family or the guardian of Fatima accepted Muhammad? They agreed. Can Hamza goes, yes or no? No. This is an agreement between the ulama. إذا الحالة عندنا حالاتنا للخطبة. الحالة الأولى إذا ذهب محمد لخطبة فاطمة ووافق وليها أو وافقت فاطمة, فهل يجوز لحمزة الذهاب لخطبة فاطمة؟ الجواب لا باتفاق العلماء. والدليل هذا الحديث. The hadith is our proof. The second example. ماذا لو رفضت فاطمة أو رفض وليها محمدا, هل يجوز لحمزة الذهاب؟ نعم أو لا؟ نعم باتفاق العلماء. What if فاطمة refused محمد or her guardian refused محمد, can حمزة go and do the khitbah? Yes. With the agreement of the ulama. Okay? Now, we have the third situation. Fatima or the guardian of Fatima are hesitating. Fatima awwaliyuha mutaraddidani. They didn't say yes, they didn't say no. ما قالوا لا ما قالوا نعم. هل يجوز في هذه الحالة لحمزة أن يذهب ويخطب أم لا؟ Here the disagreement between the ulama. Here the disagreement between the ulama. The first group of the ulama said, it is impermissible to do the khitbah for Hamza. Why? They said because they still they didn't answer the first man, and it is his right to know about whether yes or no. إذن ذهب الفريق الأول إلى تحريم خطبة الثاني لأن خطبة الأول لا تزال في محل بحث ونظر، فهذا التردد لا يعتبر رفضا. التردد لا يعتبر رفضا. By the way, we have a saying in Arabic language, not in Arabic language, in our tradition in Jordan and in some Arabic countries. It says in Arabic, قلة الخبر خبر قلة الرد رد, which means if they didn't answer you, that means they answer you, which is no, right? Which is, this is this kind of saying or tradition, this is wrong. This is, we cannot depend on it. We cannot. You as a guardian, you need to answer that man who came to ask about your dar. You have to answer him whether yes or no. But not if they didn't answer, then khalas, you need to understand that we don't want you. This is wrong. This is disrespect. Huh? Yeah, or inshallah b'sir khair, which means inshallah, you know, if Allah want khair, he will do the khair. Come on. What does mean? You know, طيب الرأي الثاني وذهب الفريق الآخر من الفقهاء إلى إباحة خطبة الثاني في هذه الحالة. قالوا لأن عدم إظهار القبول بالنسبة لخطبة الأول دليل على رفض خطبته. The second group of the fuqaha said it is okay to Hamza, to the second man, to do the khitbah. But why? They said because they didn't answer him. Okay, they didn't answer him, but also they didn't answer him doesn't mean they refuse him. Got it? But for the second group, they said they didn't answer him, that means they refused him. But how you understood it in this way? They said, look now. Because if they want him, they will answer him. Got it? Which is, to be honest with you, this is kind of like, many people understand the same way. Many people understand the same way. You come to me as an imam. Sheikh, can I have 5 minutes from your time? Okay, inshallah khair. And then I don't, you know, the day after I see you, but I don't talk to you. The day after the same thing, the day after that. So what you will understand? He doesn't want to sit down with me. Which is, this is wrong. Yahi, maybe I forgot. Right? Maybe I forgot. You don't know. But they said, the second group, they said, there was an incident that فاطمة بنت قيس رضي الله تعالى عنها ذكرت للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم that Muawiyah and Abu Jahm, they were interested in her. خطباها, they did the خطبة. So she came and said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, but the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to her, he told her to marry Usama ibn Zayd. So what they said from this hadith, we understand that, you know, Usama was the second guy, or in fact the third guy, the third person, and the Prophet ﷺ didn't tell her, oh okay, one minute, do you want Muawiyah and Abu Jahm or not? He didn't say that. So they say that give us the proof to do that. Got it? Do you understand this hadith? Because now we're going to answer them. Because they didn't, يعني, subhanAllah, look at the reason behind this hadith. If you know the reason behind this hadith, then you will understand this hadith, you know, doesn't apply to this opinion in the first place. ماشي؟ أصحاب الرأي الثاني استدلوا بحديث فاطمة بنت قيس أنها جاءت للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وقالت له أن معاوية وأبا جهم خطباها, فأشار عليها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن تتزوج بأسامة بن زيد, فقالوا هذا دليل على إيش؟ على جواز خطبة الثاني. يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما قال لها شو رأيك ما رأيك بمعاوية وأبا جهم, مباشرة قال لها ماذا؟ لا, تتزوج أسامة بن زيد. طيب, ولكن والله تعالى أعلم إخواني, الصحيح في هذه المسألة أنه لا يجوز أن يتقدم الثاني لخطبة المرأة حتى في حالة التردد. حتى في حالة التردد. The most correct opinion, والله تعالى أعلم, is it is not allowed to do the خطبة in the state of hesitation, because hesitation is not an answer. Okay, this number one. Number two, طيب, what about the hadith? We need to understand the reason of the hadith, or how the hadith came up. فاطمة بنت قيس, when she was divorced, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told her, finish your عدة, and when you finish your عدة, come to me because I have something for you. Okay? So, during that عدة, during or after, I don't remember, Muawiyah and Abu Jahm, they did the khutbah for her. They were interested in her. Okay? So she came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam not to take his opinion about Muawiyah and Abu Jahm. No. She came to him because he told her to come to him. But she told him, by the way, Muawiyah and Abu Jahm are interested. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told her what? About Usama. So Usama was in his mind even before Muawiyah and Abu Jahm. So we cannot, you know, take this hadith to apply it, you know, for the fuqaha who, you know, take it as a proof. Okay, إخواني, والله تعالى أنا. طيب, كم من الوقت عندنا الآن؟ طيب, عندنا مسألة مهمة جدا وأنهي بها. أنا ما قلت باللغة العربية والله أعلم أنه لا يجوز يعني التعريض يعني بالنسبة لحالة التردد بالنسبة لحالة التردد فلا يجوز للرجل الثاني أن يخطب على خطبة أخيه حتى لو أن يعني ولي المرأة أو المرأة ترددا في الرد على الأول، لا يجوز ذلك، لأن التردد هذا ليس بإجابة، هذا أولا. ثانيا، بالنسبة للحديث الذي استدل به من قبل الطرف الثاني، يرد على هذا الحديث أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ابتداء قال لفاطمة أنه أنهي عدتك وأخبريني فيما معنى الحديث، وأن أسامة بن زيد كان في يعني أراد أسامة لها من قبل أصلا أن يتقدم معاوية وأبا جهل، فهذا ليس فيه استدلال أصلا على ما ذهب إليه أصحاب الرأي الثاني. الآن المسألة الأخيرة التي أريد أن أناقشها، وهي حكم العقد مع الخطبة المحرمة. What is the ruling if someone went to do the khitbah, okay, and they didn't answer him, and then or يعني whether they were you know hesitated or they didn't answer him yet, they won't, but they didn't answer him yet, and then another man came to that family and was interested in that woman and did the khitbah, and they accept whom? The second one, not the first one, and they did the contract, عقد القران. What is the ruling of عقد القران? How much time we been?
About
45 minutes. سبحان الله. طيب، إذا ما حكم من عقد عقد القران مع وجود خطبة محرمة؟ بمعنى أن رجلا ذهب ليخطب على خطبة أخيه وقد وافق عليه وعقد القران بينهما، فما حكم هذا القران؟ So إن شاء الله عز وجل will answer this question. There is a lot of يعني opinions here, by the way. We'll answer inshallah this question next lecture inshallah azza wa jal. جزاكم الله خيرا وأحسن الله إليكم، والله تعالى أعلم وأحكم، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.